Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Fuzzy Bear Farm in Stardew Valley. It is the luau today, and we have a little bit of time in which we might be able yet to get a hold of a gold star sturgeon. Welcome to Living Off the Land. We're back again with another tip for y'all. Now listen up. Starting tomorrow, an unusual amount of shells and coral are expected to wash up on beaches all around the world. I'm no scientist, but I've heard it's something to do with crab mating season. At any rate, you could make some good coin combing your local beach. Very well. What about the fortune teller? Am I going to be super lucky? Neutral. Okay, at least I'm not going to be unlucky. And going to be clear and sunny all day tomorrow. Okay, very well. Let's go. Unfortunately, it's not likely that we're going to have any melons. They need 12 days. We're on the 11th. Aavak, remember to eat healthy or you won't have enough energy to work hard. I'm including one of my favorite recipes. Make sure to use ripe tomatoes. Spaghetti. Wow, thank you very much, Liz. Right, we're going to be dropping off a few things. Let's drop all of that off. We'll drop this off. I will be dropping off the trout as well. I'm going to grab, let's bring along a cauliflower. I think that'll give us a chance to at least get a decent haul out of this. I think we've got halibut, largemouth bass, chub. Yeah, nothing I think would be useful in the potluck. Unfortunately. Very, very deeply unfortunate. Righty-ho then. Do I have trout soup? I do have trout soup. And you know what? I've got a warp totem as well. Oh, happy days. Right, we're going to be making an immediate beeline. We have a little bit of time. This is coming with me. A poppy. That is going to go into... No, I'm not going to leave Leaf in there. I refuse, even though I'm desperately low on time. Okay, Leaf in. Guard the house. Right, we need to get over to the mountain lake. It is very unlikely that we're going to succeed. But damn it, we're going to try. If we can possibly get the best item to put into this soup that we can get right now... And that would be great. There are a few things that I could have brought from spring if I'd really thought ahead. I did not, obviously, and that's why I'm in this horrible mess of a situation. Oh, well. On the plus side, could be worse. I could be bad at fishing. Let's go around here. We will... Now, I hadn't planned for this at all. I actually thought, oh, I'll just fish all day. Best news ever. Okay, can we get this possibly? Can I get that all the way over there? Almost. Let's try again. No! Why? Why would you take that away? That was the perfect time. Perfect. Right, this is not the right kind of fish, but it's fine because... Well, you know what? I should possibly just let those fish go if I realize it's not a sturgeon. Just let it go. Otherwise, I'm wasting time. Oop, nope. Let's see what we can do. Come on. Okay, no. About there. No. Come on. Just a little bit. There. Okay. We may be able to get a sturgeon yet. It's not a carp at the very least. You know what? If I get out of this with something good, like some awesome artifacts, then sure, I'm alright with that. But I imagine this is a largemouth bass? Yes. Okay, what did I get? I got some bait. Now, we've got until 2 p.m. to head over to the beach, basically. Okay, what do we get? Not a sturgeon, unfortunately. But fine, we'll just try and get what we can. Another largemouth bass. All I want... Nope. All I want is a sturgeon. It's all I wanted for the last two episodes. Come on, game. Yes! Yes, game! Game, if this is a gold star sturgeon, I don't... I think it's a largemouth bass. I think it was just a very... No. It's a regular sturgeon. I need a gold one. Nope. I know I'm asking for a lot, game. Understand that I am quite aware that I'm being very greedy. But I just want to make everyone in the town happy. Is that so wrong of me? Can you really hold that against me, game? I guess you can, but... I really wish you wouldn't. Alright, we've got until 2 p.m. So we've got a little bit of time. And we're going to go and grab this. Thank you. And then we're going to grab you as well. Hopefully we get a decent artifact to compensate us for the time that we took to grab that. And then once this is done, oh, just some copper. Still, copper is pretty good. Once all of this is done, we'll stop fishing for a little while, because the last two episodes were pretty much entirely fishing. Or at least one of the days on each day was entirely fishing. There we go. Bullhead, fair enough. I can't believe I got a sturgeon and it wasn't a good one. It has to be a gold sturgeon, I believe, to qualify as the best item you could put into the pot. If not, though, the cauliflower should do okay, I'm fairly certain. There we go. Let's see what we can do. It's only coming up to 10, so we're fine. The sturgeons are a fairly difficult fish to catch, though, so the odds of me being able to catch a gold star, they're fairly slim, I think, because it's based a lot on your fishing skill versus the difficulty. My fishing skill versus the difficulty is fairly low. A better rod will help, a better bobber will help, better bait will help. All those sorts of things will all kind of stack it up. But we're staring down a fairly difficult catch right now. Especially if we keep catching algae. Who wants to catch algae? I mean, I suppose on the plus side to algae, I don't have to feel bad at all about eating it. I'm not like eating into my serious profits at that point. On the plus side, Willy's going to be really happy with me. He's going to be like, this is amazing! Ah, the fishing scene has increased so much, I'm so proud. I mean, you know, genuinely, that might be a case. Ooh, a rainbow trout. Everything is better. I don't even mind now if I don't get a gold sturgeon. I'm still going to try. But now I've got a rainbow trout. Everything just seems so much more cool. Now I'm hoping I can use that portal to get me over to the luau. If I cannot, that is going to be epically sad. Epic. Okay, that's it. We'll fish this and then we'll start running. Well, we tried our best, everyone. We did our level best. It's going to be a carp, isn't it? Yes, it's going to be a carp. Oh well, carp, that's fine. If nothing else, we're actually going to make a bunch of cash from today. Let's use it. Womp. Hello! Ha ha! Perfect! I used magic to make it here on time. Hello, Elliot. I woke up late, stepped out of the door, and found myself in the middle of all this hubbub. Completely slipped my mind. I forgot that today was the luau. That must be quite the pain, given that you live on the beach. How's the farming coming along? It must be a busy season for you. Yeah. Though I'm doing more fishing lately than farming. That's going to turn around in the next couple of days. I'll be back here by the trees. The air is a lot cooler here. Hey, Sam. Governor, who cares? Why should I care about some random old guy? We do this festival every year to give the governor a taste of everything the valley has to offer. Mayor Lewis hopes it will get the governor on our good side. That's why he's so neurotic about the way the soup tastes. That's understandable. A slow, continuous rotation is key to achieving the perfect roast. Well done, my man. I shall leave you to your important work. Whatever Linus is roasting smells awfully good. Fair enough. I mean, I can't smell it, so I can only assume that I would be in exactly the same position as Marrow if I could. Good thing I came with sunscreen. Yes. I wonder if Marrow could use some sunscreen on her shoulders. Ask, I guess. Hello. Maybe if I get on the governor's good side, he'll give my business a tax break. I wonder if he likes aged whiskey. Now, if only the mayor would stop smoozing with him all afternoon so I can smooze with him. I put fresh vegetables from my garden into the communal soup pot. Oh, excellent. I hope the soup is good this year. I fall, but what else is there to do besides eat? Talk to people. Go dance with Emily. Oh, he's taking my... Oh, no. No, he got distracted by a pot of soup. Damn it, Clint. You're your own worst enemy, you know this? When your son put a pound of anchovies in the potluck soup. Ever wondered why Sam leads the town in community service hours? The fact that this town has like a leaderboard of community service hours is, I don't know. Kind of good and kind of bad at the same time. Hee, free buffet. One of the perks of living here. Enjoy it, kid. These blasted sandflies keep landing on the food. Wow, you don't get hot pepper chutney like this in the big city. Oh, I can only imagine. Hello. Perfect weather for a beach party, huh? I would dance, but I don't want to get sweaty. The age-old conundrum. Hey, Abigail. It's tiring to socialize with everyone. I'd rather just watch the sea. Yeah. To be honest, I feel like that sometimes. And if I stand forward a little bit, it almost looks like we're the same height. I stand at the same point. I'm not that much taller than you, actually. Your bow adds at least an inch or two. Oh, Rasmodius, I almost missed you. Oi. Hello, Rasmodius. The merpeople are curious about your festivities. They become upset when you litter in the ocean. I don't litter in the ocean. If anything, I clean the bloody thing up from cans of Joja Cola. Is Willy over here? I forget. Yes, Willy is over here. Hello, Willy. Hi there, Aavak. Taking a breather? Tell you the truth, I'd rather be fishing right now. Well, I did my fishing in the morning. Get up pretty early if you want to avoid all of this sort of stuff and still get the stuff you want to get done, etc., etc. I'm bored. Vincent isn't a good dance partner. Don't worry, he'll get better. How have you stepped on my foot, dear? This is tiring, honey. Are you ready to visit the buffet soon? Oh, my lord. She's unresponsive. She is in the zone. Well done, Emily. Ah, the smell of the ocean takes me back many years, long before you were born. That music, it's too loud. Can't I have a little peace and quiet to enjoy the ocean? Oh, my. Right, well, let's have a chat, Marnie. If you brought something for the soup, climb up the stairs on the other side and throw it in. I did. It's not the best thing, but, no. Pomp, you added a cauliflower to the soup. Hopefully, it at least counts as a good gift. What a lovely occasion. It's always a joy to visit Stardew Valley. I must speak to the missus about purchasing a vacation home here. Look sharp. The governor's here for his annual visit. If you brought something for the potluck, make sure to add it to the soup. Should we move forward with the luau? Yes. Let's find out. Did my silver star cauliflower, did it do any good? I hope so. Well, folks, it's time once again for the potluck ceremony. I trust that you all put high quality ingredients in the pot this year. We don't want the governor to regret this visit to the valley. Well, governor, would you do us the honor of tasting the soup? Of course, I've been looking forward to this all year. Oh dear. Oh, thank goodness. Ah, that's a very pleasant soup. The produce from this valley never disappoints. Ah, thank goodness. Mmm, tasty. You all did very well today. Hooray! Now, who else wants some soup? The luau was a success. Good thing I brought something tasty for the soup. Time to head home. It's pretty later than 9 now. I've got another sturgeon as well. Let's drop off all the fish that we caught, because we don't need any of them. Bump, 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 bump. And all of that as well. Right, I need to do watering, like, super bad, my lord. Okay, well, I'm going to quickly get that done, and then I shall bring you back when it's done, and we can move on with the tomorrows. So see you soon. Okay, we're very nearly finished with all the watering. Thank goodness I had those awesome bounties, because I was super low on energy. Unfortunately, My plan of going out next and heading up to the community center before nightfall just to hand in the poppy. Yeah, that didn't happen, but that's fine. Ooh, more coffee beans. Really? That's particularly awesome. Let me see. Do I actually have any speed grow? Because I'd prefer to use that. Yes, I do. And then... Yeah, all right. Let's do this quickly then. One, two. I prefer to use the speed grow. It does give a reasonable amount of harvest fairly quickly. So we'll just go ahead and plant these last ones. Then we're done. But we really do need to go then. There we are. All right, and the rest is just gonna start being accrued. Ready to make something else in the future? Oh no, actually, I already popped that in there. Right, the poppy's coming with me tomorrow. I'm just gonna go straight to bed now. Oh, Leafin, it was a rough day. I didn't get a sturgeon. Well, I did get a sturgeon. I didn't get the right sturgeon. I guess that's greedy of me. It was worth trying, though, in my opinion. Right, 1,407. That's not bad, considering, you know, I did all of that before going to the luau. In fact, that's pretty good. We had some great luck with getting that those bubbles just when we needed them. But, well, that brings in a lot of money, though, oh my lord. Wow. Okay, well, not too bad. And it's the 12th day of the summer. Let's check on the weather report, shall we? Welcome to Cause 5, your number one source of weather news and entertainment. And now, the weather forecast for tomorrow. Looks like a storm is approaching. Thunder and lightning is expected. Oh, dear. Fortune teller? Ooh, I see a glimmer within my scrying orb. A shard of knowledge from the future. The spirits are very happy today. They will do their best to shower everyone with good fortune. I am very, very happy to hear that. Very happy indeed. Can I... Oh, no, they're not ready. Okay, fair enough. I was expecting them to be ready today, but apparently no. Apparently no. Right, what we will do instead, we'll just get the harvesting done because, yep, we are now at the point where we're going to start having so much to harvest every day. Give me all of the blueberries. All of them, every single blueberry. Ah, so good. So many blueberries. Anything else up here? Pepper, good times. Hello, Leafin. I wish I could throw this for you. You could chase after it. Oh, that would make me so happy in so many ways. The fact that I can't makes me actively unhappy now, by comparison. Wow. What a double-edged sword that thought was. Scallywags, basically. Okay. Well, actually, we'll also get the last little bit of harvesting here because a couple of people have mentioned how cathartic it feels to watch me harvest, and I can completely 100% understand that. There we go. Now these, as you can imagine, they're all going to be kept. I'm going to wait until we've got kegs for these. Those are going to be made into pale ale. And that's the only use I'm going to have for them. I've already watered that one. There we go. Right, well, I'm going to get the watering done. And when that's all done, I shall bring you back. And then we'll do a little bit of socializing. And pop up down the mine, I think, for today. Okay, there we go. I almost choked when I tried to bring us back then. I'm frankly amazed I didn't just cough and splutter as a means of welcome. Oh, you get. Right, we've got a lot of blueberries, and the blueberries, I might get a couple of harvests out of them. The hops are really not worth selling right now. So we're not going to. And I would really like to save the blueberries, but we've already got so many grapes. I don't know, maybe one harvest of blueberries. We've got a lot. We have got a lot that we're going to be able to do. I'm going to sell these blueberries. I'm going to make money off those. We are going to keep hold of these if we can. No, we can't. Not easily. You know what? I'll pop the rubbish elsewhere. That'll be fine. We'll drop this off for now. I need to get this being made because we could get a copper pickaxe today. Ooh, that would be... It would take it out of my inventory for 2 days, but I actually think that would be pretty useful. Yeah, I think that would be really useful, honestly. Yeah, I'm down with that, actually. We're going to upgrade our pickaxe. I'm going to drop off the periwinkle, the snail. Yes, I like this plan. I most certainly do. We'll drop the rubbish off in there for now, just to stack it up for when we get a recycling machine. Right, let's have a look. What have we got in the way of bars? We do not have much yet. We could always buy some iron. That's actually a fairly realistic goal there. And I just have loads of iron then to use. Let's not chop that down because it'll take all of my energy to do it. We will be going up to the bathhouse before too long. It's Friday, so we could go down and check out the merchant. The merchant may have something that I need. That may very well help us on our way to getting the greenhouse before winter turns around. Well, we're more likely going to need to get the greenhouse in winter regardless, because there's so many winter things that we need. However, that being said, we're now at a point in the mine where we can access winter forage just in the mine. So, you know, there is that as well. I'm not going to use up any of my food just yet, though. There's not really much point in that. But we now have everything we need to get our pickaxe upgraded. So, yeah, I think that is a really solid idea. And we're going to go for it. Yeah, okay. That would actually be really nice to get that one upgraded so soon. We'll drop these off. I was going to do a little bit of work around the farm right away, but we'll do that next. So, first, as it's possible that there'll be something truly amazing in the shop that I would really, really want to get, I'll go and check on it. That is the merchant. It is Friday, after all, but it's much less likely. Much less likely. But we'll see. We're not actually that far off being able to afford the larger backpack or to be able to afford a house for some of the animals. Oh, coconut. Potential. Melon. No, we don't need it. Rare seed. How much is a coconut? 400. Yeah, okay. I'll grab you. I will also grab another rare seed. There we go. That leaves us with enough to get my pickaxe upgraded. Sorted. I'm a little bit concerned about the time, but I should have enough money that it'll be I'll be able to make with the blueberries. Not to have to worry too much about money for now. There's nothing too much around here. I was just checking if I could see Leah down there, but I can't. So the first stop, Clint's. Get my pickaxe upgrading. Hello, Sam. Sam's trying to do a kickflip. Good luck, Sam. Don't hurt yourself. I'm sure you wouldn't. Sam is far too cool. Hello, Alex. Are you going to turn around and face me? Ah, you rude boy. What do you want? Ah, my lord, so rude. Evelyn would break her heart if she knew that her grandson was so rude. Oh, Clint. Right, I would like my tools to be upgraded. I would like a copper pickaxe. I'll get started on this as soon as I can. It should be ready in a couple of days. So about Sunday is when I'm going to be able to pick that back up. At that point, we're going to be able to start making some much better progress in the mine. Really looking forward to that as well, you can imagine. Okay, right. Let's head on up. Did I check the weather forecast and everything today? I'm not sure. Hello, Caroline. It's a fine looking day. On days like this, I help Evelyn with the public gardens. I'm really glad that someone helps. So, you're a farmer, huh? At least it's honest work. At least you had something nice to say, I suppose. Joe spends the whole day in front of that darned television set. I wish he'd go outside more. Some fresh air would do him good. Well, you know, I might not look it, but I'm fairly handy with technology. Give me a screwdriver and 5 minutes of uninterrupted silence, and he won't be able to sit in front of that television for very long. I wonder if it's anyone's birthday today. I'd better check the calendar at my PA shop. It better not be, otherwise I've thrown out my plans terribly. No, it is Alex's birthday tomorrow. Oh, my lord. I'm going to have to think of what to get Alex. Ooh. Okay. I actually haven't played on the Prairie King game in the saloon today. What are you doing in my bedroom? Hi, Abigail. Sorry. You scared me sneaking in my room like that? Yeah, I don't know what came over me. I'm not usually like this. So I've been playing Journey of the Prairie King for hours. I can't even beat the first level.
This game is ridiculously hard.
Wow, demonize. Well, either that or I'm just terrible at it. I am sure it is ridiculously hard. Hey, do you want to try this level together with me? I think I might do better with your help. Yes! I like playing games. If you married Abigail and then you could just like regularly play two-player Prairie King. Oh my lord, that would be so good. Virtually instant marriage. Here they come! Howdy. Calm down. Oh, Abigail, why? I just didn't protect you enough. Oh, okay. Can I grab that? Okay. Stay still. Stay in the middle. We'll be fine. We've got much more option to move around in the middle. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Ha 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 ha. We got this. We've definitely got this now. And nuke. We will be holding on to that one. I'm not going to go grab that coin down there. It's fine. I will grab the coffee, however. Halfway done. Oh, we're going to be fine. There we go. It's really risky going up that close to the top. Or any of the sides, actually. What on earth just happened there? I have no idea what just happened. I just suddenly vanished and appeared somewhere else. Cheat hacks. This game is trying to kill me. I don't know why. I've never done anything wrong to this game except kill all of the NPCs in it. Okay. You can all die. I was holding on to that for far too long. There's no point in holding on to a power-up. You end the game with like an inventory full of like potions and stuff. You're always holding on to it, or at least I'm always holding on to them. Wait, we did it! Okay, let's move on. Let's go. Next level. Next level. Next level. I want to keep playing. Oh, you're one of those players. Oh, man. Hey, that was fun. Well, thanks, Aavak. You seem to really know your way around adjusting. I guess that makes... Oh, really? Such a bad joke, and I grinned anyway. I'm just as bad as you. I can't complain. If you laugh at a bad joke, that's it. You're taking joint responsibility for that bad joke. This stuff can definitely be incorporated into a healthy diet. I'm very glad. Well played, by the way. Kind of wish I had a cat. Unfortunately, my dad is allergic to pretty much everything. Well, considering how much you like to play tricks on him, I don't see why you don't just get one anyway. Though that is a particularly long-standing trick. Yeah, that would be a bit rough. Oh, hi. Are you satisfied with the quality of my summer seeds? I am, actually. I'd like to sell a lot of blueberries, though. There we go. We're almost back up to where we were before. Fantastic, because I need a lot of these. 30 seems reasonable. 30 seems quite reasonable. I am not buying all of that, though. That is absolutely not happening. I do not have that kind of money. All right. Thank you very much, Pierre. It was great doing business with you. As you can tell, I'm trying to stock up so that I can guarantee that I'm going to have enough 5-star melons. Otherwise, it's going to be pretty rough. All right. Now to see if this poppy... Now, where was the poppy required? Artisan bundle. That was not it. No, it wasn't in the animal bundle. Quality crops, fall crops, new. It will probably be in here, over on the bulletin board. Let's go and have a look. Dye bundle? No. Was it field research? No. Chef's bundle? Really? Oh, okay, fair enough. There we go, chef's bundle. I need to bring maple syrup for that one as well. Okay. I've got some. I will bring it along shortly. I completely missed that one, unfortunately. Well, we're not going down the mine anymore. I mean, that one's off the cards, and I really don't feel like fishing. You know what? I should have planned that out so much better. It's like, yeah, I don't feel like fishing for the next couple of episodes. Oh, let me just get rid of my pickaxe. Because that's the most, you know, obvious way to avoid having to do any fishing. Pretty insulated from the rest of the world here in Stardew Valley. It's a good and a bad thing, being cut off from everything. I mean, it's nice and it's... Well, it's isolating. Literally, isolating. If you and Mara become friends, I'm sure she'll show you how to use that telescope out back. Thank you. Let me go see if Maro's around. No. I don't know why I'm thanking you. It's Maro's telescope. Right. I would like to... I would really like a silo. I've got to get copper at this point then for that. But we could have afforded a chicken coop. Yeah, we're going to be getting one of those, by the way. That is a given. However, I would like to shop for now. What have you got? A burlap rug? Oh, that looks amazing. I want it. However, I also want that super badly. I really want that too. Drat. Also this. Pretty much these two are the ones that I'm most thinking about. I would probably also use the wood floor recipe a little bit, depending. Depending. But now we've at least got one of the next components in the in my grand plan for the farm. However, I need to do an awful, awful lot of work in the farm, so that means I need a fair bit of energy. Thankfully, I do have my axe. So, you know what? I'll plant all my seeds for today. I'm afraid it's going to mean there's going to be a lot more watering. Not that it really messes with you as the viewer, because I tend to cut it out, but we're going to have a lot less time in the day to do stuff, and I'm probably going to be exhausted after watering, and I'm going to have to go to the bathhouse straight away every day just to be able to do anything else other than socialize. Still, it'll be worth it when we end up getting our greenhouse by winter. That will be grand. Oh, I've got a coconut as well. I need to take that with me to the, damn. I need to take that with me to the community center. What a derp, walking out without popping that in there. I'm not sure where it was going to be used. I think, was it Artisan Bundle needed it? I'm actually not sure. Let me just quickly check. Is it the Artisan Bundle? No. Quality, summer, fall, animal. No, it will be... You know what? I might not actually need one. I might have only needed that for one of the other bundles that I've already completed a different way. You know what? I don't think I did need it in the end. Oh, how rubbish. Oh, well. I'll make coconut jam. Wait. I don't think you can make coconut jam. This is where someone in the comments can tell me, actually, yes, you can. And I'd be quite interested about that. I'm not sure how that would work at all. I can't imagine jam made from coconut flesh is going to be particularly tasty. But, yeah, I would totally be down with expanding my horizons on that one. If you can, in fact, make coconut jam. I mean, if it's brown coconut, you can't even drink the milk, because by then the milk is mostly salt, or at least it's very salty. Alright, well, this is where we're going to be setting up all of our melons. There we go. Let's go and get ourselves a lot of fertilizer, all of these. The maple is going to have to come with us. I guess what I can do. So I can always give that to Haley. Haley likes coconuts. That is definitely a thing that we can do. All right, let's make all of this. We need a little bit more. Well, actually, no, we don't. We do not need a little bit more, thankfully, because we've already got all of this planted. Okay, let's get all of this down. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. So happy. Right, we should. I'm seriously hoping with this many melons be guaranteed to get a gold star melon. However, melons are such a good crop anyway that I might just go ahead and get a load more seed still. I would not be averse to that. If we have the spare cash to get a load more melon seeds. Because it takes 12 days, so this would take us up to the 24th. In the next 3 days, maybe? As long as we can get it in the next 3 days, then we should be good. And we can go ahead and just plant a load more melons again, and that would be glorious. Right, I'm going to clean this area. I know I was thinking about not cleaning it, but now I've got all of the trees down on the other side planted. They're going to be my sap trees, so I don't need to worry about this. There will be a area on the farm where I just kind of let it grow a little bit more wild, though it may be manicured, you know, kind of ordered chaos. I'm still deciding on that one. But there will definitely be a bit more of a wild location on the farm. But up here, it's not going to be. I'm going to try and make this very manicured, going up to the grandpa's shrine. It's something I wanted to do in the last one as well, but I never got around to it, unfortunately. There we go. Now, down here, we can chop down a couple of these trees. We can just start making our way downwards. I need to check that I've rebaited those crab pots. I don't recall if I did. There we go. This cross as well. Unfortunately, there's a rock that I've missed somehow. It's going to be a storm tomorrow, which is it's good and it's bad. On the plus side, currently I am increasing my foraging. If by chopping down trees, you increase forage, which is super, super useful, because at high enough forage, you learn how to make the lightning rod. But for now, that needs, I think, iron? Could be wrong. It might be copper. It wouldn't necessarily, you know, it's not like copper isn't conductive to lightning. So whatever you make it out of, I'm fairly certain, though, I'm not going to be able to make one straight away for the storm, which is a shame because we're going to miss out on the potential of all of the energy and the battery packs that I would be able to get otherwise. But we lost all of that wood, unfortunately, but there's nothing I could do about that. It was just bad placement. There we go. Really bad. Okay, come on then. It really pains me to have to slay you. Especially considering I've got bats in my farm. You know, I'm actually keeping you guys. And I'm forced to slay you here. And it makes me sad. On that note, let's go and check on the bats, shall we? Let's go and have a quick peek. Peek inside. Have we got anything from the bats? No. No, we do not. And that also makes me sad. Have I done everything? I'm not entirely certain. Yeah, they're all fine. Okay, that's fine then. Yeah. Well, you can wander around. I've got nothing against you wandering through my gardens. It's just when you attack me, there's a real pain. There we are. I've got a decent amount of wood now. We've definitely got enough clay. We've got enough stone. Yeah, I think we may actually even look to lay down the first silo. At that point, I can just start scything the grass, which would be fantastic. We've got 3 seeds to plant on in autumn, which is also really, really cool. We've also got a wee bit of something down there. So we need all of these for something in for one bundle or another in the community center. We need that as well. I think that's 4 things that we needed. I'm actually pretty happy with that, to be perfectly honest. But yes, we definitely want to look at getting the stone set up. You know what though? We can head over there now and do this. There's no particular reason not to do it right away. We've got plenty of time. Hello, Wiggly Worms. That is what I was hoping for. Another book! Fantastic! We're getting to the point that we've almost got all of them now. I'm actually pretty impressed. But we'll go over to the community center, we'll drop off these items, and then we're going to head home, I think. I think at that point we will have done everything we needed to do, and it will be bedtime. We're not going to make any money today because we sold our produce direct to Pierre. Well, that's fine. Oh, I think we might make 1 or 2 things, something like that. Right. We've got 2 items for the bulletin board. One is for the dye bundle. There you go. Actually, no. We've also got the enchanters. Excellent. And the chef's bundle. Okay, we're making some real progress there. And then 10 bats down here. There we go. Not blacksmith. The adventurer's bundle. There we are. And I'm going to need either 1 solar essence one void essence or 99 slimes. We're probably going to get the 99 slimes first. I'm going to guess at that. These are the natural things that are produced on the different levels of the mine, or the different biomes of the mine. The quartz you pretty much find anywhere. The earth crystals you only find up to level 40. The frozen tears from level 40 to 80. And then the fire crystals from 80 to 120, I believe. So we've got a little ways to go yet, but now that we've upgraded our pickaxe, so it'll be another day before we can actually collect that, we can start making progress again. Because right now, having to spend so much energy getting through each rock, it's not really tenable, really. Right, but on that note, it is time for sleeps. I've had a pretty good day. Ooh, some jam as well. Grape jelly, blackberry jelly. Let's grab something. I'm going to keep that. I am actually going to keep it. Two more grapes. We will hold on to that since it's actually someone's loved gift. There's no reason to use that just to make money. It seems really silly. And instead, we will drop these off so that we do actually make a little bit of cash. And no, I don't need to kill you, so I'm not going to kill you. We must live in harmony. Even with the monsters. The monsters are here first, honestly. It's the monsters that are letting us camp out on their land, not the other way around. Not that they quite led us, they tried to kill us actively, but it's just a bit of fun between monsters and humans. They've just got a different idea of what fun is. Right, so we made 90 on blackberry jelly, 210 on grape jelly, pretty nice return on that, and 50 on two periwinkles, and 81 on a snail. Not a huge amount, but at least we made something. I prefer to make something with every day. But there we are. And now it is going to be raining all day. Well, that is going to be it for me, though. We've run out of time. Thank you very, very much for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed. As ever, remember to like if you liked and sub if you haven't. But until next time, do take care, everyone.